Okay, so today I will tell you about the types of the carbohydrates. First of all, let me give you the overview of the carbohydrates. Actually, I gave a detailed lecture in my previous video. So, what is carbohydrate? Carbohydrate is basically the hydrated carbon, and it has three types. So, I'm going to discuss number first one. That is monosaccharides. Then on second hand, we are having oligosaccharides. Then on third hand, we are having polysaccharides. So let's move towards monosaccharides. So mono means one, and the saccharides means sweet or sugar. So the monosaccharides consist of only one sugar. Okay, then it is easily soluble in water. As we are having the example of glucose, when we put glucose into the water, it will easily get soluble in the water. So the number second characteristic of the monosaccharides are that they are sweet in the taste. Then number third one is the molecules of monosaccharides depend upon the number of carbon atoms. Okay, for example, we are having C3. It is triose sugar. Then C4, it is known as tetrose sugar. Then C5, it is pentose sugar, and the pentose sugar, it is the most common sugar in living organism. It is the only sugar that is found naturally in living organism. Okay, then on naturally in living organism. Okay, then on number six, we are having hexose sugar. So the hexose sugar we guys intake by our environment. Intake by animals, because humans are the category of the kingdom Animalia. So we are considering ourselves as animals. So intake by animals. So we are having the formula of the glucose is C6H12O6. So this one is the formula of the glucose, and glucose we guys are taking from outside. It is not present naturally in our body. When we guys are eating something, that will be breaking down into glucose in our body. Then we have C7, which is heptose sugar. Then if we guys will see about the C6, that it is a hexose sugar, as I told you that it is present, it does not present naturally in our. If we guys will see, hexose sugar is having three types. Number first one is glucose. As I told you, the glucose is the main hexose sugar. Then number second one is galactose, and the third one is fructose. So the molecular formula of these three are will be same. And glucose, it is the main sugar among these three. Then glucose and galactose are the aldehyde sugar, and fructose is a ketose sugar. okay. So let's discuss about the oligosaccharides. Oligo means few and saccharides means sugar or sweet, okay. So in oligosaccharides we are having 2 to 10 molecules of the monosaccharides. So we can say that in this we are having 2 to 10 saccharides. So let's discuss about the characteristic of the oligosaccharides. These are the less soluble in water. It is not directly soluble in water. We have to make it soluble. Then it is little bit less in taste, less in sweet taste than monosaccharides. Then the main characteristic is the what about the monosaccharides? Monosaccharides are divided upon, they depend upon the number of the carbon atoms. And in oligosaccharides are further divided on the number of saccharides, okay. So we can say that there are two type of oligosaccharides. Number second is dextrine and number first one is disaccharide. In disaccharides, there are the those sugar or the those saccharides or those oligosaccharides in which that sugar will only contain two monosaccharides. We can take the example of the sucrose. So we can take the example of the sucrose. So when glucose, okay, so sucrose is formed when the glucose and fructose combine together. When they both will combine, they will form sucrose, and the sucrose is present in sugar cane or in the table sugar that we are using on daily basis in our homes. And glucose and fructose, these both are the monosaccharides. So as I told you that in disaccharides, only two monosaccharides will combine together and they form a one disaccharide. Di means two and saccharides means sugar. So when two monosaccharides will combine together, they will form one thing. And then we will move towards the dextrine. So what are the dextrine? In dextrine, there are the 3 to 10 monosaccharides are combined. Between 3 to 10, 2 or 3 monosaccharides are combined and they will form a one oligosaccharide. For example, we are having the tetra saccharide, trisaccharide, pentasaccharide. What does it mean? That it comprises over C4, it is comprised over 3-3, and it is comprised over C5. Okay, so these are the types of the dextrine. If we take the example of the glucose drip that we guys are mostly a lot of people are using, glucose drip. If someone is getting their energy low, so the doctor would recommend them the glucose drip. So what is in that glucose drip? In that glucose drip, dextrose is present. Okay. Those patients who are not making their whose body are not making glucose naturally in their body, so the doctor would recommend them to take the artificial glucose through a drip. So what is dextrose? In dextrose, there are 10 monosaccharides present. So dextrose, it is present in the glucose drip, it is example. And dextrose is also a oligosaccharide, because over here it is having 10 monosaccharides in this.
अब इन डाइसेकर इट ओनली गिव यू द एग्जांपल ऑफ सुक्रोज. सो सुक्रोज एंड द नेक्स्ट एग्जांपल दैट इज दैट वी गाइस आर हैविंग इज ऑफ लैक्टोज. बेसिकली लैक्टोज फॉर्म्ड व्हेन lactose is formed when lactose will combine with glucose, so it will form lactose, and lactose is present in milk. Okay, it is present in milk, and lactose and sucrose, these both are naturally available in environment or in atmosphere. But we are having another example of the maltose. Maltose is formed when glucose, so maltose is formed when glucose will combine with glucose. When two glucose will combine together, they form the maltose, and maltose is not a natural sugar. It is not a natural, it is made artificially. Okay, so the bond between maltose sugar is, it is alpha 1-4 glycosidic linkage between maltose structure, and in lactose have beta glucose and beta 1-4 glycosidic linkage. And sucrose is having alpha 1-2 glycosidic linkage. Okay, glycosidic linkage. So let's summarize this thing, that maltose is comprised of alpha 1-4 glycosidic linkage, lactose is comprised of beta glucose, beta 1-4 glycosidic linkage, and sucrose is comprised of alpha 1-2, it is 1-2 glycosidic linkage. Up, let me tell you that what is glycosidic linkage, what is the glycosidic links. Glycosidic links are whenever two carbohydrates will combine together. Whenever two carbohydrates or three carbohydrates will combine together, they will form the glycosidic linkage. This is constant, and when carbohydrates are combining with each other, they will form the glycosidic linkage. So this is all for today. Now, what is polysaccharide? So first of all, we will decode this term. Poly means many, and saccharide means sugar or something that is sweet. It is seen as saccharide does mean by sugar and sweet is same as the monosaccharide or oligosaccharide. Then let's discuss about the characteristic of the polysaccharides. Number one, that in a compound there are more than 10 monosaccharides, so that would be known as a polysaccharide. Then it is soluble in water, it does get soluble. Then it is sweetless, it does not have taste. Then in very if we will take the very common examples, so we are having the four types of the polysaccharides. Number first one is cellulose, number second is chitin, number third one is glycogen, and number fourth one is starch. So let's discuss about it. What is starch? Basically, starch is a type of a polysaccharide that we guys get from the plants, from vegetables, or from cereals. What are cereals? In cereals we are having wheat, corn, rice, and these three are the cereals. So let's summarize it, that starch is a type of a polysaccharide, and from plants, vegetables and cereals we are getting the starch. Oh, in starch, the starch is made up of the long chain of glucose. C6H12O6. It is the formula of a glucose. As I told you in my previous video, that it is the hexose sugar, the most common and the main hexose sugar. So there are two types of the long chain. The first one is straight chain, and number second one is branch chain. Now, what is the difference between these two? So let me explain that. So this one is the straight chain. In the straight chain, there is a bonding between a carbon number 4 and carbon number 1. In the straight chain, because they're having the bonding between carbon number 4 gets bond with carbon number 1 directly in the straight chain. And in straight chain, we got there's a bond between alpha glucose molecules. It is made up of alpha glucose molecules, and this is known as amylose, or we can say that the starch straight chain is made up of amylose. Okay, so let's summarize this, that the straight chain of the starch is made is bonded between carbon number 4 and carbon number 1. Look, they are bonded with each other. Carbon 1 is bonded with carbon 4, and this is a straight chain. It is a type of a long chain, and in this one chain the alpha glucose molecules are present. Then this is the branched chain. Now, what is it? Let me explain that. What we guys were doing in straight chain, it was the bonding between carbon number 4 and carbon number 1 directly. But in carbon number, but in branched chain, because they're having the bonding between carbon number 1 directly to carbon number 6. The carbon number 1 will directly get bonded with the carbon number 6, and in this one we guys are also having the molecule, we guys are also having, and in branch chain also we guys are having the alpha glucose molecules are bonded between them. But the branch chain will be known as, we can say that the branched chain of starch is known as amylopectin. Okay, so this was all about the starch. In my next video, I will be discussing about the cellulose.